Alright, sorry about that. My phone got too hot, so it turned off on me. And I had to turn on my car and turn the air on to get it to cool down a bit. Anyways, what I was saying was that I felt like I ran a marathon when I was done with my project outside. And I laid down forever. So, it's common that this happens where I do one little thing that shouldn't be that difficult. And I think of myself as lazy. My kids want to go do stuff with me and I don't feel like going anywhere. And I feel like I'm a bad mom. And my husband probably expects me to do a whole lot more than I do. And so I feel like a bad mother. So I might be doing the all or nothing thinking where everything's black or white. Overgeneralization and disqualifying the positive and labeling because I'm calling myself lazy and a no good wife and mother. So while I was waiting for my phone to cool down, I came up with my rational response, and my response is that I'm doing my best. I believe this statement. I do believe I am doing my best. It may not be what my expectation is of myself. It may not be what others would be capable of doing, but I feel like I'm doing my best. And I know I'm getting better. And even though all this is hard for me, I know that my kids and my husband love me. Another automatic negative thought that I came up with while I was waiting for the phone to cool down is the automatic negative thought.
You stop reading?
Uh-huh.
Why did you turn on those lights for a little?
What you need? I had to turn on the car because my phone got hot, so I had to turn on the air conditioner. There I go with my automatic negative thought again, thinking I'm a bad mother because my daughter was just here and I felt like I kind of pushed her away. She says she wants to go somewhere with me, but I told her I don't have my shoes on and I'm in my pajamas. YouTube world can't see that, but I've got my pajama pants on right now, so I'm not going anywhere. I told her to go ask her dad if she can spend some time with him because she has two parents, so she can spend time with at least one of them, right? It doesn't have to be me. I'm so lazy. Ugh. There goes my automatic negative thought again. Okay. Could I do better with my daughter? Sure, I'm sure I could. I could do better with both of my kids. I just gotta make up my mind to do it. I just gotta decide when I'm gonna spend time with her and make the plan and then actually do it. It's just not right now, okay? I'm sorry, it's just not right now. My other automatic negative thought that I came up with was that my distant family doesn't care about me. This is something I think about often when I don't hear from my stepmom, my sisters, my brothers, my aunts or uncles, my grandparents, even my own mom doesn't call me. I have to call her. And she's the only one that I call. I don't call my siblings anymore because I just didn't feel that they appreciated my calls. And by appreciate, I don't mean them answering the phone every time, Crystal, so happy to hear from you. No, it was like they would ignore my call. Or when I talk to them, they're like, yeah, uh-huh, yeah, no, yeah. There was no back and forth. There was no connection between me and them. It just felt like I was the only one asking questions. It felt like I was the only one that cared. And it was really bumming me out to call them. It was bumming me out to think about calling them, because I felt like I was the only one that gave a damn about the relationship. And I felt like they didn't care about me. So, what kind of cognitive distortion is that? That's mind reading and emotional reasoning. I'm assuming that they don't care about me. And I'm also assuming that just because it feels like they don't care about me, I'm assuming that my feelings are correct. That's emotional reasoning. But the truth is, my rational response is that I really don't know that for sure. I could try harder on my end. Do I want to? Not right now. Maybe when I'm older. Maybe when they're older, they'll try harder with me. That's my rational reasoning. Everyone's busy. Everyone's got their own lives. My rational reasoning is that they don't think about me like I'm thinking about them. And maybe when I was their age, I didn't think about them either. Maybe when they mature a little, they might. Because all my siblings are younger than me. That's why I'm telling myself this. They're all younger than me, so maybe when they become my age, they might want to reach out to me in the future. That's my triple column technique. Part two. Next, I'm going to talk about the daily activity schedule. So let me go ahead and stop the recording and start fresh with that one. And we will continue talking about this Feel Good book by David D. Burns, MD. As you can tell, I've only read this much, so I've got lots more to read. But I figure if I do this work while I'm reading it rather than when I'm done, it'll be easier to process and a lot better in bite sizes like this. So, that's all for now, and I'll talk to you in a few minutes. Bye-bye.